Hi guys, Crafty Katsa here. My fourth attempt on doing the iTop tutorial / demo. I've been asked by quite a few people to do it, so I'm going to give it a go again. This is the iTop. There are two parts to it. There's the big rubber part, which is what you squeeze down on your brad. And then there's another part, which is it's a lot easier than what I'm making it appear, believe me. It's just getting these little things pushed in to move them. This part here is where you put the back on, where the stick part is, and then it gets pressed together with the rubber part here, and that's how you make a brad. First, you can use either stencils or a punch. There are three punches for the three different size brads, which is what I wish I had have done, is got the punches, but I didn't, so eventually I will. What I did do is I got the stencils. There's a circle part here, and you just pick your paper. In this case, I chose some, it's got some foil in it, some Valentine paper from the punch pad of Martha Stewart. And it's got X's and O's. So you take it, and you trace your circle. Then you take this part, this is the important part of the stencil. All those little tabs, after you cut the shape out, those are what you press down and it pulls your brad paper together so it will look right. So you trace that next. And for time's sake, I have already done that. And I've cut it all but one notch, which I'm going to do here. I had the video done a few times, and the one that was really good got rejected because it was 3 minutes too long, so I was kind of disappointed with that. However, these are all lessons you learn when you do something, when you learn to do something. So there we have our piece. Now, there are two parts, as I said, to the brad. There's the brad daddy. This piece you place on top of the metal part. Then there is the backing piece with the little stick on it. But put that aside just for a minute. Going to this is much easier. I just have trouble with this button here when moving the part around. Oh my goodness. I don't know why, because I wasn't having this much trouble before. That doesn't want to move. There, I just had to hit it the right way, that's all. So, this piece back in. We're gonna put our paper on. How are we doing for time there? Okay. Paper back on there, make sure it's centered. And there we have it centered. And all you do now is you squeeze the handles together. See the notches going down? And you give it a second squeeze. Bring it back up. Now, you see see the notches there that are sticking out? You take them and you press them down with your thumb. Make sure they're pressed down really good, because you don't want them sticking out when you finish your brad. Now we take the bottom piece. There's a hole in the metal part where you stick that stick thing. And then you move the rubber part over top of it that your paper's in. And you have both pieces in place. Now we squeeze it again. You hear that little click? That means you did it right. You release it. Turn this part up. And your brad's in there. So all you gotta do is just pull back on the rubber and it releases the brad that you made. Set the eye top aside and we're done. That's your brad. The cute X's and O's with the foil in there. Isn't that cute? I hope you liked it. Sorry for the trouble with the part there. It is actually very easy to do. I'm just all thumbs tonight. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope this answered your questions. Bye-bye.